KRLD News has just learned of strange goings-on on the Return of the Living Dead Part 2 set. We switch now live for an on-the-scene report.
We're here in Valencia, and as you can see, the set looks deserted. There have been unsubstantiated reports of an unusual mist in the air. This Lorimar Motion Pictures presentation is produced by Tom Fox and written and directed by Ken Wiederhorn. Earlier today, we spoke with Wiederhorn on the set.
This is clearly fantasy horror, and I think that what fantasy horror offers the audience is the ability to go into a movie theater and be scared out of their wits and go out into the street, into the daylight, and know that it's not going to follow them out onto the streets. The challenge was more in doing something funny and then scaring somebody immediately after that. To like really run the gamut, like in 15 seconds. To have the audience laughing and then catch them up short suddenly. What I'd like it to be is the Police Academy of horror movies.
Wiederhorn created roles for James Karen and Tom Matthews, who starred in the first Return of the Living Dead. In this new film, they play grave robbers who eventually turn into zombies.
Chronic infectable rigor mortis.
Is it serious?
Is dead serious?
The first film, I did get to play the romantic interest, and I think I kind of fulfilled that romantic interest in this film, because I actually do get to eat my girlfriend's brains in this one.
If you love me, you'll let me eat your brains.
Ah! Billy! You stay away from me!
Oh, Brenda, your brain smells so good, so rich and spicy.
Spicy?
Yeah.
Joey, I am not the dead guy!
Hey guys, have you seen any zombies?
That way.
That way.
Excuse me, have you seen any zombies?
Yeah, somewhere around here.
Come on guys, maybe we'll find some zombie actors in here. This is very strange. Earlier today, these sets were crawling with nearly 100 actors playing zombies. The emptiness is very creepy. My crew is beginning to get nervous, and frankly, so am I. And I can't stop thinking about what those zombie faces look like. Makeup artists created more than 100 different zombies under the supervision of Kenny Myers.
We have some of the most gruesome collection of books amongst all the people in this trailer. Some of them I cannot even look at. Others are amazing. We use death investigation books. We use books on diseases, all types. There was no time to sculpt 100 individual looks. So what we did is we set a very finite number of faces that were changeable. We could get 4 or 5 different looks out of one face. Anything from very decayed to recently dead. The rest of that characterization comes out of the actor wearing it.
They're looking to eat the brains to ease the pain of being dead. At the same time, they're experiencing their pain. Please, use it.
Under the direction of Derek Lochran, each zombie actor was encouraged to create unique movements.
This way, you're like,
and then as the body sways, the balance changes and the head goes to the other side like that.
You're going to have to act with other parts of your body that are visible, such as your eyes and your head.
Now bug them. All right, now start to slow down. Oh, that's nice.
Excuse me, gentlemen, would you mind commenting on the strange happenings on the set?
How did he find out about that? How did you know that?
It's very closed. I mean, no one's supposed to know about that.
How did you find out about that?
Please, no. No more of this.
No
please.
More, yeah, no more pictures.
I lost on my way to my car. Can I go? I need to get out of here. This is a little weird.
Strange? No. No, not that I know of. I mean, nothing stranger than happened on any other regular movie crew. I mean, we may look a little weird, but it's just makeup. I mean, this is just rubber. Like hair.
Hey, what's going on?
Brains. Flesh.
Are you all right? Oh, no!